cargo freighter. The skipper of the Charon was waiting, like the ferryman of the River Styx.
What the hell?
I doubt if the letter was a receipt. Rico Muerte had come to town to do more than just sort out family troubles. Exhibits number 1, 2, and 3. A briefcase of money, a sniper rifle, and an envelope with one word neatly printed on a folded piece of expensive paper.
Mayor.
It didn't sound like a mafia contract at all. It was too cold and too to the point. Thank you.
Buenas. Aquí dame dándole a Max Payne. Me falta todavía rato. A ver si pasamos la parte 2 al menos ahorita. No, no tanto.
I had found Boris Dime's ship.
Thank you.
rust had crept over the sides of the cargo steamer a long time ago. Boris Dime would be on board. I'd have to smoke half of his crew to even get near the gangplank. Guns were probably being kept in the hold, buried amidst the rats and oily water.
Angie,
tell me, how much did Dime cost you? I bet it was more than his name.
Max Payne.
Right the first time.
You're dead, punk.
You sure you're not confusing me with Boris here? But you are right, of course. Pretty soon we should get together and have a talk.
You son of a...
Pissing Punchinello off was a dangerous game. But when people get mad, they make mistakes. I should know. That's where I wanted Punchinello, mad enough to trip over his own feet. Preferably into a grave.
Time.
says different is calling me a liar. Vladimir here. Collect all the guns and ammo you want. Meet me on the bridge afterwards.
Did you get everything you need?
Check.
I owe you. Anything you need.
This is my solo. When I'm through, Punchinello won't be anybody's problem anymore.
Clear as vodka. But anytime you get between a rock and a hard place, just whistle. This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
You really get a bang out of this big time gangster act, don't you? Even with all this firepower, I figured I couldn't get to Punchinello at his manor. I could only hope that he wouldn't pass a chance to hear me beg to see he's won. This is Max Payne. I want to cut a deal.
Payne, you're a dead man.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. I got your ship and her cargo. I want to meet. No pain, no gain. Capiche?
You know my restaurant?
Yeah, I know it.
One hour.
Punchinello's restaurant had seen better days. Snow was falling like ashes from post-apocalyptic skies, but that was outside. Things would soon get hot in the Don's restaurant. I knew it was a long shot, Angelo Punchinello actually showing up, but there was no crime in hoping. Punchinello was burning to get me. The feeling was mutual. He was trying to put out my flames with gasoline.
¿Qué onda, Vanaguro? Aquí seguimos con Max Emiliano Dolores.
The mobsters have been guarding a real treasure, the way out of this disco inferno.
Todo es tiempo vale en este juego. Si lo sabían bien, si no, te la pelas.
Seen my smoke signals. The Mercedes was revving to go, almost drowning out the Banshee wail of the sirens.
You coming? We'll drop you off at the Punchinello Manor.
Sounds good to me.
When this is over, look me up. I could use a professional like you.
I'll keep that in mind. The night groaned with cold. The garden lights flickered nervously. In their light, the falling snow was dead white before the darkness ate it up. I had heard the stories. The trio were mad dogs. They'd have hung the heads of their enemies over the manor gates if the capo had only let them. Punchinello wanted pain. He'd see the pain. The trick in my situation was that there was no trick, no matter what the movies tell you. No rules, no secret mantra, no roadmap. It wasn't about how smart or how good you were. It was chaos and luck. And anyone who thought different was a fool. All you could do was to hang on madly, as long and as hard as you could. Someone had graciously left the back door open for me and killed the guards. My money was on Mona. I knew the trio would be standing between me and Punchinello. I had read their rap sheets, thick as phone books. No one would be walking out of here alive. The numbing cold of the broken night had followed me in. Upstairs, the trio tangoed down the manor halls to the silent rhythm of their murderous hearts. The blood of their victims rust on their lips. Vince Mignano, Pilot Providence, aka Big Brother, and Joe Deadpan Salem. The pistol was a frozen lump in my hand, piercing the skin, gnawing me to the bone.
Al revés. Esta es la última misión de la parte 1. Digo, el parte 2, perdón. Y ya nos veríamos al último capítulo después. De eso. Que la verdad no creo que lo acabe hoy. Tenía un detalle con el audio ahorita. A ver, vamos a ver. Es por acá, sí. Qué bueno.
It didn't take me long to run into the trio. Lisa Punchinello was the word on Lisa Punchinello.
This will stop anything. Take cover.
Don't stop at him.
This will stop anything. Take cover.
It was too late for her.
You're a real angel, Max.
Max Payne.
Talk to me.
Alfred Woden. You've got company. Helicopter just landed on the manor grounds. You must hurry.
The more the merrier. Vince Mugnano. Punchinello's trio was done for.
Outside my door. Hurry. He's coming for me. You gotta hurry. Please.
I could hear Punchinello on the phone begging for help. He should have been saying his goodbyes. Punchinello was a pushover. The moment I stepped into the room, he folded like a deuce before a royal flush.
No, wait. I was just doing what I was told. I couldn't refuse. She's someone high up. Government, maybe. I don't know.
He was trying to buy more sand for his hourglass. I wasn't selling any.
No, I told him nothing. No, I told him nothing. No, I told him nothing. No, I told him nothing.
Game over, Max Payne.
I could tell when I was outgunned. It was time to take another beating. The mystery witch was a real barracuda. Trouble on dagger heels, a smoking assault rifle in her hand, and an army of killer suits behind her.
How sweet. I get to kill two birds with one stone.
Sooner or later, it was going to catch up with you.
Mr. Payne, it's time to show you the benefits of my brew. Be a good boy now.
You'd find that Lady Luck was really a hooker.
Ah!
You were fresh out of cash.
Gentlemen, we're done here. Take me to Cold Steel.
She had just given me an OD of Valkyr. I could feel green fire eating my brains. They turned to steam. They did a fade on me. I'd never had a chance. The witch had got me just as sure as if she put a gun to my head and pulled the trigger. The shadows rushed me. Bruised mugshot faces hungry for revenge. They knew my weak spots and closed in for the kill. The floor turned into a vortex of green blood. I fell.
The flesh of fallen angels.
Oof. Ya, la última parte tipo Silent Hill. Vamos hasta la madre esta parte.
Who's there? Max? Max, is that you? Max? Where are you, Max? Please. No, please, Max, no. I'm sorry. Please don't, Max, no. Max? Where are you, Max? Please.
The letter was staring at me. There was something disturbingly familiar about the letter before me. The handwriting was all pretty curves.
You're in a graphic novel.
The truth split my skull open, a glaring green light washing the lies away. All of my past was just fragmented still shots, words hanging in the air like balloons. I was in a graphic novel. Funny as hell. It was the most horrible thing I could think of. The weird piece of paper looked dangerous. There was something disturbingly familiar about the letter before me. The handwriting was all pretty curves.
You're in a computer game, Max.
The truth was a burning green crack through my brain, weapon statistics hanging in the air, glimpsed out of the corner of my eye, endless repetition of the act of shooting, time slowing down to show off my moves, the paranoid feel of someone controlling my every step. I was in a computer game. Funny as hell, it was the most horrible thing I could think of.
Esta parte. Hay que caer y brincar exactito en los pinches puntos estos. Ahora el primer brinco. Uy. Aquí voy. Ya la cagué. Me había salvado con mi bebé.
Who's there? Max? Max, is that you? Max? Where are you, Max? Please.
was staring at me. The weird piece of paper looked dangerous.
Ok, aquí la parte complicada. También esta parte tengo que salvar. Ok. ¿Dónde quieres atacarme bien despacito? Ok, es así. Pero es que... Como darte en la posición para un brinco ni siquiera está tan fácil. A ver, llega. Uy, apenitas. Aquí ya no me acuerdo por dónde. Mal intento. Ni modo, la rega. Esta parte es castrosísima. Aquí lo que voy a hacer es jugarlo un poco arriesgado. A ver si me puedo aventar hasta allá. Debe ser... Lo bueno es que esta es la última parte así. Okay. Aquí me voy a detener. Voy a salvar. A ver si puedo caer derechito ahí. No. Ok, load. Tengo que ir más hacia acá antes de poder hacer eso. Cada brinco lo tengo que dar como si fuera cirujano. No. Aquí creo que tengo que caer, si mal no recuerdo. Tengo que caer. Chale. Popcorn. Thank you. Nope. Que caerse en el que que se la tiene muy apenitas. Creo que aquí está el regalo. Ahí está ya. Oh. Después de todo este batallo. A ver, me voy a despacito aquí. Okay. Es algo como Luis Fonsi aquí.
Uy.
Aquí vamos a salvar y a cerrar esta parte, por el amor de Dios.
Max, no, Max!
Murderer, you killed her.
Lo bueno es que ya la última parte así de ese tipo.
Max, something happened at the office today. A strange memo. Something about Vikings.
Honey, I gotta run. You can tell me all about it this evening.
Have a nice day, darling.
The bullet holes were rubies on her chest, blood glowing on her ivory skin. She was so beautiful. The killer was smiling.
The flesh of fallen angels.
Slowly, the green nightmare faded, leaving dark stains on my soul that would never come off. I felt like flatlining. I was all shook up. I woke up in a cold sweat, sick and tired to the bone, lying in a puddle of my own puke. The hag had said take me to Cold Steel before it had all gone crazy. It was a clue, the only one I had. It took me forever to crawl back to my feet and hit the road, but when I did, I drove straight to Cold Steel Foundry outside the city. There was a whole lot of action around the place for a freezing winter night. Trucks coming and going, men running. I had the drop on the mystery witch. She thought I was dead. I was on her blind side. I was going in. The bad trip had put me in a crazy mood, adrenaline pumping through my aching veins. Staggering on the mill roof in ice and snow and wild wind, I was a ninja. My kung fu was strong. I wasn't hitting anybody. At best, I was Superman and Kryptonite about to fall through a skylight, down to where it was all going down. A half-abandoned industrial area in the middle of nowhere. The factory was a perfect front for any number of illegal activities. In the belly of the plant, molten metal boiled and bubbled like a witch's brew.
Lo único malo es que siempre que empiezas un acto ya te dejan sin nada. Bienvenido al muy entretenido juego de tumbar explosivos. Killer's Call Command. Ah, no, ¿cómo es esto? Ahora mismo. Tunas. Olvidaba que en esta parte los enemigos aguantan más a Cole. Aquí se me va a tener que llevar la metralla. nariz. Allora, questo. No, es para el asunto.
Can you believe it? How about they sleep with their rifles? I bet they've given them names.
I guess. So...
Talkie military lingo could mean only one thing. They were getting ready to destroy the evidence and vanish into the night. I was so close. The hidden truths were just around the corner. folder on the table told a grim tale. The mercenaries were running a tight operation, paperwork and all.
Merchandise missing again. A chemist had tried to smuggle it out for his own private party. Locked him up in cell B7 and D6's old test facility to wait for proper processing.
I was close enough to hear the secrets, just beyond the next doorway. The monitor showed me the way. Processing diagrams fill the control room screens, all but one. An elevator titled D6 on one of the screens, somewhere onwards, past rows of ovens, in the core of the plant.
Thank you.
Las cosas como me lentan. Hasta la caída. Típico problema de cosas de PC que no. Aquí me van a chingar toda la bola acá.
Taken on the role of the mythic detective, Bogart as Marlowe, or as Sam Spade going after the Maltese Falcon to unravel all the mysteries. Following a path of clues to that final revelation, even if it would take me down to the cold, cavernous depths of a grave.
You can't do this! My men are still inside!
Do you have any idea why this is called Operation Dead Eyes?
I think he's dead already.
Let's do it.
Attention all personnel. The self-destruction sequence has been initiated. Evacuate the complex
We've
immediately.
We've got company.
Repeat. The self-destruction sequence has been initiated. Proceed to the nearest exit.
I had seen the logo on the floor before. There was an old army bunker under the steel.
Exit immediately.
The chemist had been using the workstation when he died. The half-life of the lab rat had ended online, his password attention blinking on the screen. 665, the neighbor of the beast.
In here! Hey! Get me out of here! I'm innocent! There! Thanks! I thought I was gonna die in there for sure.
I need you to get me through the decontamination chamber airlock.
You're crazy! No way! The place is blowing up, for Christ's sakes!
Either that or back to the cell. Your choice.
Okay! Okay! I'll do it! I'll do it!
Was caught in the middle of the deadly web that was the Valkyr case. Project logo.
Top secret. Project Valhalla. U.S. Army. Yggdrasil Network. Valhalla, the otherworldly place in Norse mythology.
On the screen, the dagger-heeled woman had come and gone a long time ago. There was nothing more for me here. The bunker's name was acting as a self-fulfilled prophecy. Piece together a jigsaw, and the final picture is you finishing that same puzzle. A mad, green-eyed killer standing behind you. An urban legend come true. The Project Valhalla test subjects had been the mad junkies who had murdered my loved ones. The rest was simple body count math. It all pointed to her. Ms. Valkyr. The factory went up in a fiery inferno behind me. All my leads were dead, turned to smoke and dust. I had lost my way. I hadn't slept in a million years. I felt thin as death. I've been living on an endless supply of week-old donuts. They were fuel for this crazy furnace inside my head. I couldn't remember when I had last seen the sun. I was on a permanent graveyard shift. When the darkness fell, New York City became something else, any old Sinatra song notwithstanding. Bad things happened in the night, on the streets of that other city, Noir York City. I was in an all-night diner, downing cup after cup of coffee that tasted like engine oil, when a new message from BB got me back on the killer track.
What the hell happened at Roscoe Street? Maxie, I'm going out on a limb here. We need to talk this through, come up with a plan. 2:30 a.m., the Choir Communications Garage.
The more I thought about Alex's murder and the frame-up, the more it felt like an inside job. I should have seen it coming. BB had sold me out, and now he wanted to finish what he'd started. The garage was dead. BB showed up in his tailor-made suit, gold watch, and cufflinks to match. All way beyond a cop's pay.
Maxie.
Oozing suave charm, he was guilty as hell. What the hell does BB stand for anyway? Backstabbing bastard?
Come on, don't be like that. Have a cigar.
I don't smoke.
Maxie, you have no idea how big this is. It's huge. You have no idea.
I think I do. You're a bribe-taken bent cop who sold out his partner. Those mobsters in the subway were a dead giveaway. Hard to miss. Bet it was exactly like this with Alex. Up close and personal.
You can't win this one, Max.
No, but I can make damn sure none of you do either. BB turned out to be another cardboard cutout bad guy. A bad cop on the take. A cowardly right-hand man fleeing from the scene, leaving his paid thugs to do his dirty work.
A huevo.
Oh!
puta madre. Va tan larga esta parte. ¿Cuántos pinche niveles de esto es? Que ya sea la última parte acá. Ay, esto es ridículo. ¿No les pega la pinche granada?
No, I must do the right thing.
The payphone started to ring. Yeah.
Thanks, Payton.
Whatever does it for you.
This is Alfred Wooden. I can give you the name of your enemy. Come to the Asgard building presently. We are expecting you.
Wooden was waiting for me on the steps of the old building.
Mr. Payton, let's go inside. The others are anxious to begin.
The others?
Despite the general misconception, this building actually predates the City Hall by 2 years, thus being the oldest municipal building still in use here at the foot of the Brooklyn Bridge.
No kidding. The old man played tour guide as he led me through a dark domed hall. The answers I was after loomed large ahead.
Mr. Payne, I would like to introduce you to my colleagues in what we call the Inner Circle.
You've been watching too much X-Files.
You have seen the files on Project Valhalla. We can fill the gaps, provide you with the information missing from those files. We were all involved in the early stages of the project during the Gulf War.
What's the catch?
We would very much like to blow this thing wide open, but our hands are tied. Her name is Nicole Horn. She was the key figure in Project Valhalla. When the funding was discontinued, she simply refused to quit. She knew exactly what she had in her hands. Nicole Horn is the president of Acer Corporation. She has more than half the city in her pocket. This must be kept under wraps. If you try to go public with this, we will deny any knowledge. We need you to take her out. Afterwards, we can protect you. Make all the charges go away.
That was the cue for the killer suits to kick in the doors and swarm inside. It was an impressive floor show, but I decided to leave early anyway. It was only a one-story fall. Lucky me.
Bueno, muchachos, ahí lo voy a dejar porque ya estoy cansado. Ay, cabrón. Larga lo deseo. Hasta luego.